You know what's really interesting to me is the fact that for more than a month now, we have watched Donald Trump file his election challenges. They may all be ending now because Rudy Giuliani is currently in the hospital with COVID-19, and that may be, you know, the out that Trump needed to, you know, move aside and say, oh, well, I can't do it now. My guy's gone. But here's the thing. If people had been paying attention from day one, they would understand that most of these lawsuits that Donald Trump filed, even if they had been successful, still wouldn't have overturned the results of the 2020 election. Joe Biden would still be the president-elect, even if nearly all of these Trump lawsuits won. Like, if Trump had gone to court with the best lawyers and they prevailed and they had the evidence they said they had, they hadn't challenged enough votes in most of these states to actually overturn the results. Like, this thing he's complaining about right now in Georgia with the signature match. You're not doing the signature match. You're not doing the signature match. Well, first of all, they don't even need to do that. But second of all, even if they did, that's not going to overturn the results. And even if you did overturn Georgia, Biden still becomes president. Just like I think it was Arizona, where they were challenging a lot of votes saying that this number of votes was fraudulent. This many. And they wanted these votes thrown out. Okay, well, Joe Biden won by this many. So even if you threw out this many, Biden still would have won the state. And I'm using size comparisons because I don't remember the numbers off the top of my head. But they didn't challenge the overall margin of victory. They challenged a smaller number. So do you see what I mean, folks? And similar things, by the way, happened in Michigan, Wisconsin, and Pennsylvania. Sure, they were filing these lawsuits, trying to get things delayed or thrown out. But none of them would have actually switched the results. And the reason I'm even talking about this today is because it highlights the importance of reading beyond the headlines, folks. And I'm sorry, but that is not something you are ever going to get from corporate media. You're not going to tune into MSNBC and watch them talking about the fact that, hey, these lawsuits really don't matter. They're all stupid anyway. They're all fraudulent. But even if they weren't, it wouldn't do anything. So honestly, like, the collective freakout that you're seeing among some on the left still over Donald Trump, it's overblown. This guy can't do anything to stay in office any longer than he already has. January 20th, noon Eastern, he's out of there. And he would have still been out of there even if most of these lawsuits had been successful. It was never about overturning the results of the election. The point of all of this was, for one, him to not look weak in front of his supporters and just be like, well, I lost, Joe Biden wins. No, he couldn't do that. That would hurt his own ego, and it would hurt his standing with his base. So he had to act like, oh no, it was totally stolen from me, guys. Somebody do something. Rudy, get on it. Oh no, now he's sick. Darn it. Oh man. Oh, well, we got robbed. We'll beat him next time. Yeah, that's what he was going for. And of course, just the simple delay factor of maybe pushing it back a little bit so we didn't have to deal with reality, because as we all know, reality and Trump have seldom gotten along. But that's what this was about. It was never, ever about actually turning over the results of the election. It was just giving the illusion that that was possible.